Moving on very quickly, we, like I mentioned earlier on, time is of the essence. So I'd like to call on our next speaker, who will be talking about what my generation got wrong, the Managing Director of Sahara Group. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause as we welcome Tanya Cole.
They've called me into an elders group, and I sometimes wonder, but again, we tend to think of ourselves as a bridge between generations, and so I think I must be somewhere in the middle, and since they don't have a group for the bridge, I find myself with my much respected elders. But one of the things that I know from my generation's point of view is that when we had an opportunity to make the kind of changes that you have the opportunity to do today, we turned our backs. We turned our backs on politics, and we went into the kind of business that I do today. And we have done great. We've done very great within our business. A lot of my generation today are the people that you look up to in the business world. They own banks, they own insurance companies, they own airlines, they own oil and gas companies. Many of them do have private jets. They do everything that you look up to them and you say, this is the way that I want to be. But then, something strikes me, and it always has. As I began to try to influence the lives of young people, looking at the influence that politics has had upon my business, upon the things that we take important, where people make decisions for us and it affects every single thing that we do. As soon as we started trying to make those changes, I found out that the task was monumental. Getting up and trying to deal with individuals one after another to change mindsets one step at a time can take a lifetime. In fact, it can take more than a lifetime. And so I sat down with an elderly gentleman, somebody who is in another generation, and I said to him that this is what I want to do. I'm trying to reach a generation. I want them to get up and make a change. And my generation and their generation are struggling to make changes within this nation that we have. And he said something to me, and that is what I want to say to you. He said, as long as you are outside of the decision making in this nation, you cannot make a change. As long as you stay outside and you are talking on podiums, as long as you stay outside and you are trying to deal with people one after another, you will not be able to make a change. He said that change, if you really, really want to hit the masses and you want to make policies and you want to do things that will hit people at every level, from the very rich to the very poor, from those who are impoverished, from those who are healthy, if you want to hit in every level, everything that you have spoken about, whether it's on education, whether it's on health, whether it's in policies, whether it's in the police, the army, every single level. He says that there is one place that makes a difference, that can touch every single level, and that is within the government. That you must get in to politics, you must get into the government, you must have these young people that you are talking about become actively involved in the decision making in this country. As long as they don't, no change will happen. They can talk from the outside, they will not make a difference. And so, this is where the message is. What are you doing about it? How long will you stay outside? How long would we have sessions like this? How long are you going to be thinking about making a difference and not make that difference? You need to get up. You need to begin to get involved. But how do you get involved? What is it about getting involved? I was on the radio station today and a young lady called in. And she said that if the youth get up and they go, we must think about now. That the thinking about now is this: when any youth gets up to get involved, then they get killed, they lose their lives, and so they are not interested. That the youth, and this is your generation speaking now, he says that the youth of today, what they are interested in doing is to stand back and watch what would happen in the next elections. That is the greatest mistake you can make. If you take that position, I can assure you that your dreams will not come to pass, you will sit down and you will be frustrated, you will not have anything to take home. So, as you are going away, as you leave this place, do yourselves one favor. Decide which party you are going to join. It doesn't matter whether you believe today that APC is the right party or PDP is the right party. That is not the point. The point is that you must get involved. You must become a card-carrying member. You have to get up and go and make a difference. Your generation today does great things in movies. They do great things in entertainment. But when Fela was singing, Fela sang about things that have made him a prophet. Fela spoke about the government and he made changes and spoke about things that will make changes. Is your generation ready? Are you ready to get up and make a difference? Thank you.